पिताहमस्य जगतः माता, आई एम द फादर एंड मदर ऑफ दिस यूनिवर्स. भगवान, देन व्हाट अबाउट ग्रैंडफादर? हु इज योर मदर एंड फादर? पितामहः अहम्, माय ग्रैंडफादर आल्सो आई एम. व्हाट डज इट मीन? आई एम द अल्टीमेट कॉज. मदर एंड फादर मीन्स आई एम द कॉज ऑफ दिस यूनिवर्स. एवरीथिंग हैज कम फ्रॉम मी. There is no other cause greater than me. I am the causeless cause. I am the material cause as well as efficient cause. This is a technical term. The creation, for any creation, there has to be material. That material also has come from me. That is called Mata. And for any creation, there has to be an efficient cause. The one who creates, like the potter, that also I am. I am the efficient cause, I am the material cause. Abhinna nimitta upadana karanam, technical term. But even otherwise, it's a beautiful verse to meditate upon. I am the father and mother of this universe. Now see, whenever these statements are there, they are all for contemplation. So you can just keep on contemplating upon these terms. Now, whenever we are in trouble, what is the best solution? From where will you get the best solution? Isn't it from our father and mother? Especially when we are children. And of course, we are children. We don't know anything about this cosmos. We don't know anything about ourselves. So from where will we get the best guidance? From our father and mother. So Bhagavan says, come to me. I am here to guide you. Why are you wandering here and there? Suffering? Come to me. I am your creator, so I know what is good for you. I know your entire past. So what is good for you? I know. So I will do that which is good for you. If you want to know God, the only way is through love. How to develop love? In order to develop this love, the entire drama of samsara is played. So what is this drama of samsara? So the child is born and the child receives love from father and mother. Correct? As the child grows up, the child starts receiving love from father and mother. And a time comes when the child grows to become a father and mother and then gives love. So this is the whole drama. In the beginning you receive love from your parents. Later on you become a parent and you give love. So in the process what happens? You become a master in understanding love. Just extend it further, you are able to experience love from God. As a child, I know how to make my parents happy. What I should do, what I should not do. Correct? And as a parent, there are certain expectations from my child and there are some duties as a parent towards my child. Correct? So all these aspects become clear in this drama called family life. And once your heart has been fully grown in this love, then you will be in a better position to understand His love. Right? How to become a good child in the eyes of the Lord. You come to know. So this way you can go on meditating upon these terms. How can I become a good child? Should I fight with my brothers and sisters? No. I should be loving them. Then I will be lovable in the eyes of God. Isn't it? We are all children of God. We have common father and mother. So how should I behave with others? I should not hurt them. I should love them. I should help others. All these values come into picture. So Bhagavan says, I am the father and mother of this universe. Also Dhata. Next term. Dhata means what? Dhata means the giver of fruits of action. Karma phala dhata in this context. He is the right person to give us what we deserve in life. Why is it so? It is so because he is omniscient. He knows everything. We get what we deserve and not what we desire. And he knows what we desire. Gurudev's quote. How does he know? He knows it because he is the very consciousness in us. He knows everything. कर्तुराज्ञया प्राप्यते फलम. ऑल द फलम वी गेट कर्तु आज्ञया प्राप्यते. बाय द कमांड ऑफ द लॉर्ड यू गेट व्हाट यू डिजर्व. द पॉइंट इज देयर इज ए जस्ट गॉड, ओमनिशियन गॉड. सो वॉट एवर वी आर गेटिंग इज अ राइट थिंग. डोंट कंप्लेन, डोंट ग्रम्बल. यू डिजर्व वॉट यू आर गेटिंग, गुड और बैड. नेवर कंप्लेन. धाता, भगवान कैनॉट मेक ए मिस्टेक. इज अ परफेक्ट अंपायर. यू नो अंपायर्स इन क्रिकेट मैचेस दे कैन मेक मिस्टेक्स बिकॉज दे आर ह्यूमन. टू अर इज ह्यूमन नेचुरल. सो देयर फॉर वी हैव दिस, वॉट इज दैट, थर्ड अंपायर एंड ऑल दैट. But as far as this umpire is concerned, there cannot be any mistake. Everything perfect only happens. Because he is called Adhyaksha. Maya Adhyakshena Prakriti hi Suyate. In my presence, Prakriti is creating the world, isn't it? Meaning what? He is a presiding deity. He is seeing everything. What is happening? He sees without eyes. He hears without ears. Upanishad mantra says. He doesn't need your eye to see. In fact, it is because of him that your eyes are able to see. This is God. Dhata, Pitamaha, Vedyam, the one thing to be known. In this world, if there is one thing to be known, and that is He alone. Pavitram Omkaraha, the most auspicious Omkara He is. Which is the very essence of the entire Upanishads and the Vedas. If we ask, what is one word? Can you summarize the entire Vedas in one word? Then that word is Om, Omkara. Representing this consciousness, which is most auspicious, pavitram, Rik Samayujirevacha. I am the hero of all the Vedas, whether it is Rik Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda, Tharva Veda. In all the Vedas, I am the one who is discussed upon. Then I am Gatihi, the destination. Gatihi means destination. That where we are supposed to reach, where the journey comes to an end, that is called Gati, destination. Just like a river, where does the river culminate? It culminates in ocean. In the same way, where does our journey of birth, death, samsara, where does it culminate? It culminates in Him, Gati. Consciously or unconsciously, all of us, whether saint or a sinner, we are all moving towards Him only. So therefore, He is the final Gati. Bharta. Bharta means what? Nourisher. I am the nourisher in you. In the form of wind, air, in the form of food, in the form of water, I am the one who is nourishing all the beings. The heart, the kidney, the liver, the blood circulating system, the digestive system, everything is functioning because of Him. I am the Bharta. See, these are all terms to meditate upon, contemplate upon. Whenever you feel, I don't know where is God, who is God, just observe these things. Pay some attention to the heart as it beats. See His hidden hand in everything. The air which you breathe, who has given this air to you? The water you drink, the food, how it comes, you know? The food is there on your table, where has it come from? All those factors, when you just meditate upon, contemplate upon, you will find that you are dependent upon infinite million factors. You are here, breathing, kicking, alive, it is only because of infinite factors. And all those factors, who is the one who is guiding? Who is in charge? It is Bhagavan. So He is the Bharta. Prabhu. Prabhu means the Supreme Lord, the Omniscient, Omnipotent, Omnipresent. All-powerful Lord, Prabhu. Sakshi. A beautiful term, Sakshi. Witness. Who is the witness of everything that is happening. He is Sakshi, therefore He has become Dhata, the giver of fruits of action. Sakshi. Sakshat Ikshate, it is Sakshi. The one who sees with his own eyes. Nowadays in every place you have this, you know, the board. This area is under the supervision of CCTV, monitored by CCTV. And the moment you read that instruction, then everyone becomes decent, very decent. Because everything is recorded, isn't it? They say 99% of the crimes, it has come down because of the CCTV. That 1% is because those people who don't know how to read the word. So everywhere you find this CCTV. In big malls, in jewelry shops, etc. It's a very good technique. Someone is watching you. Everything is being noted. You are not going unnoticed. That is the meaning. If only we could be aware of this great Sakshi within, all the crimes of this world will vanish. If only we could infuse this knowledge at the very young age into the minds of the children. Whatever you do, remember it is not going unnoticed. The police may fail, the law may fail, the government may fail, but even then, nothing goes unnoticed. The good you do comes back to you because there is someone who is watching. The bad you do comes back to you because there is someone who is watching. Isn't it? And this CCTV is very, very unique. Its battery never fails. You don't have to change the battery. And its memory is not in GB or TB. Gigabytes and terabytes. It is IB, infinite bytes. Your entire, what you call, history is being recorded through this CCTV. Not only of this birth, of countless million previous births. And the births which are going to come. Everything is recorded. And the beauty of the CCTV is not only your physical actions are recorded, it records your thoughts also. Ordinary CCTV don't have access there. But this CCTV is perfect. That's why it is Sakshi. It sees as it is, everything. That's why we say we can't cheat God. He knows everything. And therefore, confidently He gives you what you deserve. Because He has seen it. See, just if you meditate upon this, we will not have the courage to do something wrong, isn't it? Now and then, just keep remembering this, that there is Bhagavan watching. Nivasaha. Nivasa means abode, dwelling place. All of us, we reside in Him. Like the birds residing in a tree. Entire creation resides in Him. Nivasaha. Sharanam. The ultimate refuge. What is Sharanam? Bhagavan Shankaracharya writes, Artanam Prapannanam Artiharaha. The one who removes all your afflictions, sorrows. The remover of your sorrows. He removes the sorrows of whom? Artanam Prapannanam. Those who have taken refuge in Him. Not everyone's. The one who have totally taken refuge in Him, He is the one who removes their suffering, sorrows. Thus, Sharanam. And Suhrit, a very good friend. Again, Bhagavan Shankaracharya writes, who is a Suhrit? Pratyupakaran anapekshah san upakari. The one who does good for you without expecting anything in return. The worldly friends are such that whenever they do something good, they expect something in return, isn't it? They are all conditional love. But here you will experience unconditional love. He is your well-wisher. Does what is good for you. And He doesn't expect anything in return. Suhrat. And then, Prabhavaha Pralayaha Sthanam. Prabhavaha means Srishtikaranam. Pralayaha means layakaranam. Sthanam means srishti, sthiti, laya. Sthanam means sthiti karanam. So srishti, sthiti, laya. Creation, sustenance, dissolution. All these happen keeping Him as the substratum, as the support. Prabhavaha, pralayaha. Sthanam, Nidhanam, storehouse, repository of everything, Nidhanam, treasure house, Bijam Avyayam, Avyayam Bijam, imperishable seed, imperishable seed of everything. That I am. Then what does Bhagavan say? Tapami aham. I heat up this earth. Aham tapami varsham nigranami cha utsrajami. So the entire process of rain is described here. I am the one who heat up this earth and take water. And after having taken water, I release it in the right place. Nigranami utsrajami. Just imagine if suppose if the government is given this job of supplying water to all, all the beings in this world will perish in a moment's notice, isn't it? So the most important phenomenons of nature is taken care by the Lord. He has not given us any freedom to interfere there. Everyone needs water, and this water has to be supplied at the right time. So Bhagavan has taken the total responsibility, isn't it? Just imagine how much of water is needed to water this entire planet. Bhagavan says, I am the one who is doing it. So when you see a cloud passing by, you should be reminded of whom? Bhagavan. Don't be reminded of the scientist way of explaining. It is cloud, nothing but water vapor. Yes, of course, it is. From a superficial level, we accept. But try to see that hidden hand of God in everything. In every cosmic phenomena, you must be able to see that hand of Lord. And then you will find that devotion for God welling up in your heart. If you analyze this cosmic phenomena only through the eyes of a scientist, you will become at the most a scientist. You cannot become a bhakta. Now remember, as a spiritual seeker, I am interested in developing. So we must be able to see the hidden hand of God in everything. In sunrise, in these waves that you are seeing, you are hearing rather. That infinite expanse of ocean. What you must be reminded of? The infinite power of God. When the sun rises, you must see that majesty, the glory of God. When the clouds pass, when the rains come, you should be reminded of God. If you are reminded of God, then you are a true devotee. Let every experience of yours in this world, let it remind you of God. Varsham nigranami utsrajami amritam chaiva mrityuscha. I am immortality and I am also death. Mrityu is also I am. Deathlessness also I am. Many times for us deathlessness is fine. Birth is fine, but death is something which we consider very inauspicious, etc. If you are a true devotee of God, you will consider death also as auspicious. Because death also happens by the will of God. And anything what Bhagavan does is auspicious. How can there be inauspiciousness in something which God has ordained? Isn't it? Just imagine if nobody dies. Our Puja Gurudev used to say, your great, great, great grandfather also will be living in your one BHK house. Just think of the misery. So, it's a blessing in disguise. The old has to go and make place for the new. Isn't it? Come to this world, learn from it and vacate. So therefore, mrityu is a blessing. Moreover, in this creation, every destruction is a constructive destruction. Gurudev used to use this term. Constructive destruction. What do you mean constructive destruction? Whenever something is destroyed, something new, something better comes up. Isn't it? A seed is destroyed, a plant comes. Flower goes, fruit comes. In the same way, this destruction is also constructive destruction. Everything is auspicious, including death. We must learn to welcome death with a cheerful smile. And this is possible only when this knowledge is available. What is that knowledge? Body alone perishes, I, the pure consciousness, has no death. Then you are not afraid of death. You will welcome death. If this knowledge is not there, the body might have become infirm, full of wrinkles, full of leg pain, head pain, back pain. Even then the fellow will hold on to this body. But suppose you have this knowledge, you will welcome it. Arre, my old body is taken away and new body is going to come. You will celebrate it. Death becomes a cause for celebration when you have this knowledge, isn't it? Actually, whenever dies, we must celebrate. And this celebration can happen only when you see that auspiciousness in everything that happens in this world. Amrutam chaiva mrityuscha sat asat cha aham Arjuna. Whatever gross thing you see, sat. Whatever subtle thing you can't see, asat. Everything is me alone.